Right, Mr. Charitable, you had some.
No, but let me clarify. I'm not saying that you and I, three people, should start experimenting. I'm talking about the city. City means corporation, city means NGO, city means citizens, etc., etc. So I'm saying in a very formal way, we need to do all this. But what Srini brings up also is a good question. My question would be, where was my ward councillor for the last 1 year? I mean, this tendering was not a sudden move. I mean, we all knew about the tendering. In fact, I used to tell my NGO friends that, you know, 6 months ago, that now is the time for us to, if you have the expertise, please go to the corporation, sit down with them. They're not going to call you. I mean, see, just because we talk about public participation doesn't mean corporation is now suddenly going to, 1 year ago, they would have called you and asked you what you want and all that. You could have taken the initiative. So I'm doing self-criticism for myself and my own fellow NGO activists and so on. No point talking about this issue on the day of the tender.
So it's about personal initiative here.
I'm talking about personal initiative from experts and NGO people. Tomorrow is the tender. Once the tender is done, you can't change the tender. You can't change the contract. You know. So we should have been talking about this 1 year ago. Media, NGOs, corporation, councillors. It takes months to figure out these solutions. You know.
Now, but if I were to ask you this question, when we speak of personal initiative, are we then, in a way, providing a free pass as far as the bodies that are authorized with this responsibility? Are we allowing them a free pass?
Not at all. All I'm saying is that we have to recognize reality and we have to get to the promised land, if that's the way we want to go. If the reality is that the corporation's ability to do certain things is very weak, then we have two choices. Either we accept and say, this is my fate and I'm going to take whatever corporation gives, or because everybody claims they have solutions, and there are a lot of good people in the city who know what needs to be done. There are foreign consultants, local consultants, all kinds of experts. So the point is, it's not a question of lack of expertise. If the corporation...
So greater interaction is what you're
specifying. Yes, exactly.
On.
1 year ago, we could have started this.
Right, so solutions is, of course, one issue that we'll talk about in just a few minutes. But let's take a look at this issue from a legal standpoint. You stressed on the fact that personal initiative is very important. From a legal perspective, now the union government enacted the Municipal Solid Waste Management and Handling Rules in 2000, according to which it mandated the local bodies are required to take part or to have sustainable practices such as source segregation. So here's a law which in a way simplifies things, that these agencies, these bodies are required to do so, and they are the bodies that will be held accountable. So do we in a sense are looking at a situation where perhaps rules are in place, the mechanisms are in place, but neither of two of them are being followed?
Yes, this is what has happened. Neil Metal, in that contract, if you see, source segregation was there. But what has happened? And what was the role of Chennai Corporation? Nothing. In spite of citizens coming forward and telling them, see, this is what has happened. You are not, the service provider is not doing source segregation. You know, they were not bothered at all. See, it's a thing. They don't bother that, you know, citizens have any role to play in this. And they feel that centralization of garbage, as long as, you know, they keep every house clean and then throw it at someone's backyard, you know, it is fine.
Right. That's the thought coming in. Now, at this point, when we speak of, as Mr. Srinivasan pointed out, that the mechanisms are in place, but they're not being adhered to, what is stopping the government? Is it lack of funds? Is it lack of political, is it lack of will? What are the factors that are impeding growth or impeding, as you said, we're at zero right now. We aspire to be at 100. We need to get at 50 first, but to get there at 50, what are the factors that are impeding the growth?
I think, to clarify what I was telling, you know, I think we're underestimating the problem. Yeah. So imagine if a tender tomorrow, a contractor comes and gives, underestimates the number of roads he's supposed to clean. Yeah, and you've given the contract out. He is going to get paid 100 rupees. Then he discovers that there are 100 other roads he's supposed to clean. Then he realizes that whatever he does, he's going to go into a loss. Whose fault is it? My point is, how you set up the tender, how you do all this PPP or private, public, all these things are complicated subjects. And unless, again, I know I'm repeating myself, unless we get these things right, I'm telling you, our grandchildren will be sitting on your show and saying the same things. You know, point is, the capacity is missing in the city. So this doesn't mean that we should just let everybody off the hook. That's not the point here. Point is that we can. There are sticks, there are carrots. We can keep claiming that there are rules in the book, but so what? Rules require capability to implement, isn't it? Simply creating rules is not going to make a difference. So it's nice that we have rules. But now let's focus on the capacity of our corporation to deliver those rules.
Of course, coming back to the statement of the corporation there, to take it in this context, of course, the question that they raised to us was, Kodungi or Perungudi are two options that we have. If today you tell us not to dump the garbage here, What can we do? What are the options that they do have? Let's begin with you, Mr. Srinivasan.
See, every bureaucrat in the corporation, from the commissioner, has been talking this over the last 11 years. You know, no one has changed because they have that set mind to it, you know. Because, see, privatization of garbage, they have found, brings in a lot of money. See, and what is it? There is no accountability at all. You know, you pay, I think, almost nil metal now, they pay close to about 750 rupees a ton every day. And if you see that out of 3,000 tons, almost, I think, 1,000 tons is cleared by them. You know, there's a lot of money involved. And, mm-hmm. you know, they pick up debris, they pick up, you know, all sorts of garbage, and then finally dump them and claim their money. You know, so there's a lot of money involved in it, and they don't want this, you know, holy cow now to be, you know, left dry. So they feel that any solution that citizens are bringing forward is not ideal.
It's not viable, right? But let's speak of course, we've discussed the issue at hand, we've discussed the advantages and the disadvantages of a centralized model or a decentralized model. We also discussed the legal issues here. Let's talk about now solutions. You spoke of Pune, that there are models in place. Mr. Chirubal stressed on, of course, personal initiative, greater interaction between civil bodies, as well as, of course, these NGOs, the experts, people who have the expertise. So let's work, let's talk now about solutions. Integrated solutions are one, is the buzzword as far as garbage management is concerned, waste management. What can you tell us about that, and how viable is it for a city such as Chennai generating huge amount of garbage?
See, integrated waste management facilities that is now being proposed both at Peringudi and at Kodunganayur are no solutions, because one is that all waste is going to be brought there once again, and it is now going to be made into briquettes, pellets, and ultimately it is being sent to cement plants, mm-hmm. where it is going to be used as a fuel. Now, these garbage, nature being that 60% of it is organic, you know, it needs a lot of binding. So, you know, it needs your plastic, it needs all your things to be bound. And at the cement plant, you know, it is going to be burnt, which means that once again, the environment around these plants where people live is going to be polluted severely. So, you know, the solutions are basically, you know, trying to move it from here to some place 200 kilometers away. You know, and these are not at all viable, and they need to be totally, you know, taken away. And simple models of decentralization, small biomethanization plant, that in Pune they have done it, you know, 10 tons of garbage, you know, in 15 places, they have started doing this. So all your organic waste is fed into that. Mm-hmm. The slurry is used by farmers, you know, for their crops.
Now, Mr. Srinivas, of course, mentioned a few pilot projects there which are being deployed in different parts of the city. Can we expect these products to be perhaps replicated on a much larger scale when we speak of the entire city?
But even there, for example, I mean, what do you think, if I ask you, what do you think about incineration? If you ask a lot of people, they'll say, let's incinerate, because Singapore incinerate.
Right.
But there are NGOs who are very sensitive about this, and they say, no, incineration is a very bad idea. Because if the local contractor doesn't run the incineration plant properly, he throws dioxin into the air, and you and I end up breathing it. Yeah. So who do you listen to now? Incineration or no incineration? Point is, we claim that we have done this in CMBD and so on and so forth. What is the result of it? Is it working? You know, is it actually functioning? For example, the STP plant in Pallikarnai, mm-hmm. As far as I know, it's working, but it's not. Once in a while, they just open the tap and let the sewage go into the Pallikarnai. So point is, we can claim that there are a lot of things have happened, but who knows what is working? You know?
Right.
So I think, again, I'm coming back to the point of there has to be transparency. There has to be a more open understanding of what works and what doesn't work. Also, with respect to these kinds of technologies, whether it's protection of methane or incineration and so on, there has to be a lot more debate, because I think the language is changing. Because if I were an official, if I were to assemble four NGO people and ask them opinion, I'll get 40 opinions. Yeah.
Right.
So even there has to be a debate, because even among NGOs there is confusion and a lot of disagreement. Yeah. Point is, I think our goals are the same. There has to be reduction in garbage, there has to be recycling, there has to be segregation and composting and so on. How do we get there is the problem now. Yeah, I don't think anybody is saying we should dump more in Pallikarnai. I don't think anybody is saying we should, at least citizens, I'm not saying. Point is, what is the next solution? I think we need to have this debate for the next many months. You know, any quick solution is fine. In a the other problem will be scalability. You may be able to do it in one place, you may be able to in two places. Then what happens, for example, if I ask you a question, if I don't segregate tomorrow, what are you going to do to me? In fact, I asked the corporation official once. You're talking about, everybody talks about segregation, yeah? What monitoring and enforcement mechanism do you have where I don't segregate?
There have been many reported
What are you going to do to me? You
know? There have been reported many cases where people took the initiative of segregation and they were put back together by the corporation vehicles.
So that's a very common concern that we face. Exactly. So unless we have those checks and balances, otherwise people will become even more cynical. Yeah? After all this discussion, the corporation says we have done A, B, C, and then if it doesn't work, we go back to our same Indian mode of saying, you know, nothing works, you know, there's no monitoring, there's no enforcement. So I think we need to get all these details right. Otherwise, we are going to be here many, many years talking about the same issue, same Pallikarne, same dump yard issues. So quite a bit way to go.
Right. No, if you take, you know, I think one is that the present chief minister is starting on a new innings, you know, she has begun. You know, she has been credited with the rainwater harvesting. And no one can deny today, all over India as also the world, that Chennai has had a successful thing. Not only Chennai, across Tamil Nadu, groundwater levels has risen up. And it was a mere legislation and made sure that enforcement, you know, is good. Now, what prevents the same government from trying to do this so segregation of garbage?
So it has worked, and we can, of course, work on this trend.
See, all it needs is that once it is a legislation, there is a good enforcement mechanism, it could. But my only thing is that the people have seen, especially private companies, have seen that there is a lot of money in this garbage. Because again, certain NGOs have said, you know, waste to wealth, you know. So now the industry has taken this up. It is now talking of, you know, carbon credits and all that, which is what is dangerous. Because ultimately, it is the citizens who are going to suffer. It is either you or me in our backyard where centralized landfills sites are coming up and garbage is being, you know, burned and used for RDF, pelletization.
Right. So is that the answer to...
disagreement, because, you know, there are a lot of other models available. Private is not always good or bad. Public is also not always good or bad. Tomorrow, if corporation takes over everything and they don't collect my garbage and dumps it into Pallikarne, who do I go and catch? Yeah.
See, at least so, there is an, a sense of responsibility. We can catch our councillors.
Not really.
We can go ahead.
Neil Metal also same thing. No.
Neil Metal is totally, there is nothing, you know, because
so
see,
the idea is, in a way, they do form this axis of sorts. No.
See, I would still think that, see, we have done over the last 11 years, we have done this privatized model. In only certain pockets of Chennai.
Onyx did a
But Onyx, what did Onyx do? It threw the garbage. Onyx was the first service provider who brought in so much of garbage, and what was earmarked as 75 acres of land has grown into almost 300 acres of land.
Srini, where do the government corporation guys dump their garbage? They don't make it disappear. Yeah? They dump it somewhere.
So see, at this point,
it's not like government makes it disappear and private guy dumps it in Pallikarne. Everybody's dumping somewhere.
At this point, when we debate between private versus PSU, and we have a private plus PSU nexus in operation, which model do we look at which can provide us perhaps the best solution for handling garbage?
There has to be competition. We cannot have a private monopoly or a public monopoly, because as a citizen, I want my service. I don't own a company and I'm not going to get a check from them tomorrow or something. Point is, there has to be competition. There has to be checks and balances in the contract. So there should be severe punishment and a good reward. Yeah? This is how other countries have solved their problem. We are acting as if we are reinventing the problem, as if this is the first time in the history of mankind who has found garbage and how to... This has been solved in many different ways. Yeah? Australians do it one way, Singapore does it another way, Hong Kong has problem with landfills. Yeah? So this is a universal problem, and there are 1,000 different models available. We should debate and pick the right one for us.
Yeah, right. Your final word.
No, I'm against privatization of models, because one is that there is a lot of profit involved in it, and it is basically the end user who suffers. You know, a corporation with its commitment to people, you know, has a role to play. Citizens have a role to play here. So a decentralized model where the partnership is between people and corporation, I think can come out with a very good solution.
So the people to corporation connect. Now we're running out of time here. Time for final thoughts. We've discussed of course complex models that have been deployed, which have been used. We've spoken of debate. We've spoken of Pune acting as perhaps a good model. We've seen of course different international cities such as Singapore, such as Australia employing different models. Let's break it down for a final talk or for a final thought on I as an individual, I as a resident of Chennai, how can I contribute to get away with the chalta hai attitude, to get away from the cynicism and to contribute in my little capacity as a citizen? How can I contribute when I speak of course, garbage management? Your first thoughts.
I think as a regular citizen, keep the pressure on the corporation. Absolutely, you should have to keep the pressure on the government. And as an expert, if you're an expert in the city, you have an extra obligation to now sit and, instead of saying this is a corporation's problem, I'm not saying NGOs are saying that, okay. We need to go the extra mile and engage with the corporation and set a deadline for this. Let's solve this problem in another 1 year, yeah. Let's make sure that, like what Srini and everybody else is saying, let's have decentralized garbage collection, at least in one more. Let's have some benchmark and then learn from it and replicate it across the city.
Take it one step at a time is the message coming in from Chirubal. Mr. Srinivasan, your final thoughts?
Yep, see, citizens will have to understand that, especially urban residents, that they cannot throw garbage outside. You know, that they need to compost. Organic waste can be composted within their, whether they are in individual houses or in apartment complexes. Most of the non-organic waste can be recycled. Let them start making an attempt.
Right, so that's, of course, the final thoughts coming in. Thank you, gentlemen, for joining us and sharing your expertise and your perspective with us. It was great having you here this evening to discuss your perspectives as well. Well, that's the view coming in, of course, that though the responsibility also lies with the big stakeholders, we have also got to play our little roles in terms of handling garbage. Well, with that, we're heading into a very short break. We'll come back with lots more updates for you on the other side. Keep watching.